In the heart of the Netherlands, where the Rhine River flows to the North Sea, lies the vibrant city of Rotterdam. Join us on our exploration tour. Hey guys, what's up? We are Henny and Jozef. We enjoy traveling and are fascinated by places with seas, beaches and rivers. In this video we tell you something about the enchanting city of Rotterdam and uncover the secrets that make it a truly special destination. We made another video about Rotterdam, ports and beaches of Rotterdam. You'll find the link below. This video is about the city itself. A large maritime heritage, a nice riverside setting, a lively center, stunning architecture, and a vibrant cultural scene. That is Rotterdam. Rotterdam is nestled in the middle west of the Netherlands. It is a city close to where Henny grew up. We can create long movies about this city, but we will try to show you the most interesting things. The River Rotte was originally called Rotta, which is a combination of the old Dutch words of muddy and water. In 1270 a dam was built along the river, and there Rotterdam was born. Rotterdam's history is marked by both prosperity and devastation. In the 13th century, a humble fishing village was granted city rights, and over the centuries it evolved into one of the most significant ports in the world. The port grew slowly but steadily into a port of importance, becoming the seat of one of the six chambers of the Dutch East Indian Company. That company was the first multinational in the world. The company's voyages departed from here, and Rotterdam became a hub for trade. The greatest spurt in growth, both in port activity and population, followed the completion of the Nieuwe Waterweg in 1872. The city and harbor started to expand on the south bank of the river. The Witte Huis, or White House skyscraper, inspired by American office buildings and built in 1898 in the French Art Nouveau style, is evidence of Rotterdam's rapid growth and success. When completed, it was the tallest office building in Europe, with a height of 45 meters. However, the city's resilience was severely tested during World War II, when it was heavily bombed, resulting in extensive destruction. Rather than mourn its losses, Rotterdam embarked on an ambitious reconstruction project. Leading architects and urban planners came together to give the city a fresh, innovative look, characterized by modern architecture. The daring design choices led to Rotterdam being called Manhattan on the Maas. The most famous resident of Rotterdam was Erasmus. He was a Dutch Christian humanist, Catholic theologian, educationalist, satirist and philosopher. You find his name everywhere in the city. Today, Rotterdam stands as a thriving metropolis, a symbol of urban renewal. The city's skyline boasts iconic structures like the Erasmusbrunnen and the Cube houses, attracting architecture enthusiasts from around the world. Rotterdam is Europe's largest seaport and a major logistic and economic center. Its bustling port remains a cornerstone of the Dutch economy, connecting Europe to the globe. An increasing number of large cruise ships visit the city every year. Rotterdam has a population of about 670,000, reaching about 1.6 million. It is home to over 180 different nationalities. Its neighborhoods reflect the city's multicultural population, and this diversity is celebrated in local festivals and events. The city has the first metro in the Netherlands and now has an extensive metro network. The first design of the city after the Second World War was that of a car central city. That has changed. Wide roads have been made narrower and there is much more room for public transport, pedestrians and cyclists. Rotterdam itself has a regional airport, but from Amsterdam Airport it is only half an hour by train. Don't take a taxi, they are expensive here. If you come by car, park your car outside the center and take public transport. Dutch cities are not car friendly. If you park in an official P&R parking lot, you only pay for the ticket for the metro or tram. If you are coming to the Netherlands for a few days, purchasing an OV chip card is a good idea. It costs 8 euros and you must top up money, but a single ticket for a ride is much more expensive. It applies to all public transport, buses, trains, trams and even ferries. Rotterdam is renowned for its innovative and diverse architecture. It has a skyline that keeps changing. The Erasmus Bridge, designed by Ben van Berkel, is one of the most recognizable landmarks. It is a cable-stayed bridge that connects the north and south parts of the city. The cube houses, designed by Piet Blom, are a striking example of avant-garde design. These tilted cube-shaped houses are a unique sight and a testament to Rotterdam's willingness to push boundaries. The new central station was designed by a group of architects and is sensational, both outside and inside. Another remarkable building is the Markt Hall. It has a daily market for more luxurious foods, but you can also enjoy delicious food on site. Houses have been built on the outside. Rotterdam has still some well-preserved historical buildings in the center. The Laurenskerk is a beautiful example of Gothic architecture that dates to the 15th century. Rotterdam hosts the International Architecture Biennale, a major event that brings together architects, urban planners and designers from around the world to discuss and exhibit ideas in architecture and urban development. Rotterdam offers a myriad of activities for visitors. You can take a boat tour through the port, explore the modern and interesting city, or visit one of the theaters or cinemas. The Euromast opened in 1960. The tower became a symbol of post-war Rotterdam. On nice days you have a fantastic view of Rotterdam and the surrounding area. The city is a paradise for food lovers, with countless restaurants serving Dutch specialties and international cuisine. Cycling along the city's extensive network of bike paths is a fantastic way to explore the city. And if you're a fan of shopping, there's a wide variety of shops and markets. This is the latest phenomenon. Urban surfing is being built. Soon you will be able to surf in the middle of the city center. The museum, Boijmans van Beuningen, houses an impressive art collection spanning centuries. It is currently being renovated, but the new building depot is open and is a must visit. Of course, there is also a museum about architecture. Here you can see development projects worldwide and discover how architects and urban planners achieve innovation. The Wereldmuseum offers a glimpse into the world's diverse cultures. One of the most unique museums is the Netherlands Photo Museum, showcasing the evolution of photography. For the modern art enthusiasts, the Kunsthal Rotterdam presents an ever-changing collection of contemporary masterpieces. And in the summer, you can find art on the streets, such as this nice exhibition. What truly sets Rotterdam apart is its unshakable spirit. It's a city that emerged from the ashes of destruction to redefine itself as a symbol of innovation and progress. The fusion of modern architecture with a rich historical backdrop gives the city a unique character. In Rotterdam, the past meets the future and tradition meets innovation, making it an extraordinary place that embodies the resilience of the human spirit. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and press on the like button.